All right, guys, what we're going to do is add some calcium chloride to the beaker, and we're going to actually use a magnetic stir to stir our solution. You'll be measuring. I'm just going to put a small scoop of calcium chloride into the solution. The magnetic stir looks like a little, I don't know how you'd describe that, a little like capsule. Put it in, put it on the stir plate right in the center. This one has stirring and heating. We only need to stir. Here we can kind of determine the RPMs we want to use. You can kind of just visually tell by how fast the stir is going. Right now I'm at 360 RPM, which is going to be plenty fast. But what you find, neat little thing, if something takes a long time to dissolve, this is the method we want to use. You have 50 milliliters of each solution. Sodium carbonate, calcium chloride. Notice they're both clear. When you mix them together, you're going to get a precipitate. So we've mixed the two things together, the calcium chloride and sodium carbonate. We're now going to set up our Buchner funnel apparatus to use vacuum filtration to basically separate the solid from the liquid here. This white thing here is a Buchner funnel. It's got a cork on it. There's a lot of different ways this could be, but it fits into this flask perfectly, like so. This needs to be sealed in this area here, so it's got to be a tight fit. The hose is attached here, and this end of the hose is going to go onto the yellow, because that is our vacuum. Make sure it's nice and secure there. Our filter's almost ready, but we've got to set up a piece of filter paper. So you're going to take one full-size piece of filter paper, but we've got to cut it down to fit in here. So the easiest way I've found is to trace around this with a pencil and then cut the diameter slightly smaller than what you've traced. So we have to make this filter paper fit this funnel. To do so, I'm going to put the funnel down flat on the paper and trace around it with a pen or pencil. So I've put a circle onto it. If you cut it on the line, it's going to be too big. So kind of what I have done in the past is I'll cut it in about eighth of an inch or so. It doesn't have to be perfect. You'll see why here in a second, but cut it in about an eighth of an inch. So I've got basically a circle, and then you've got to test to see if it fits. It has to lay just about flat, so if there's any like extra pieces, you can quickly modify your cut filter paper by trimming a few corners or rounding those edges just a little bit better. And as long as it lays flat, then and it covers every hole. Take careful note here, there's holes inside the Buchner funnel. The filter paper must cover all the holes. So we've cut the filter paper for our Buchner funnel. It fits now. We place the funnel back into the flask. We're going to turn on the vacuum and test our apparatus. So if we turn the valve all the way on, you might not be able to hear it on the video, but you can hear clearly that there's a vacuum sucking. To test that and to see if everything's sealed, take your wash bottle and spray and wet the entire filter. Get close in on that filter, Mary. You want to make sure the entire filter paper is wet. You should be able to see the little holes through there. Now you're ready to filter. Take your solution, and if you look closely, a lot of the solid has now settled on the bottom. In the beginning stages, to decant this off, you simply pour slowly into the funnel. And the hope is that we're collecting any solid in the top. Before I actually go, I just want to demonstrate what you have down in the bottom yet is the solid that I hope to collect. You can keep adding. This is where we're going to actually get quite a bit of the solid to come out. Zoom in on that. You'll notice that the solid doesn't come out real easily at this point. If you take your wash bottle, hold the beaker at an angle. You can kind of wash out that solid all in one step. You will not be able to get every last grain of the calcium carbonate, but you'll get pretty close. At the end of the day, you should have your solid on top, and the bottom solution should be relatively clear. We have found in this particular lab there's some very fine grains of calcium carbonate that will go through the filter paper. There's not a lot we can do to prevent that, so keep that in mind when you're writing your error analysis. Where we're at now, I took the filtrate from this flask, put it back in the beaker. We're gonna try to filter it one more time and see if we can get any more of those particles to collect in the filter. So we're gonna turn the vacuum back on, and I'm gonna run this filtrate through our filter again. And see if we can get any more of those particles. Looks like we're getting some. Something important to note, the water level of the flask, never let it get above halfway, because we cannot let it get into the vacuum itself. So you shouldn't ever be approaching that line, but if you get over halfway, then you need to turn off the vacuum and dump your filtrate. Zoom in on that. We did clear up quite a bit, so we did get some more of those particles. That will increase your yield. At this point, you've filtered your calcium carbonate. You remove the filter paper from the Buchner funnel, and you have a damp sample of calcium carbonate. We need to get this dry. Take your filter paper, put it on a watch glass, and you're going to put it in the oven at a very low temperature. Do not turn the oven up really high, you'll burn the filter paper. So, very low temperature. Dry the calcium carbonate. You'll know when it's dry because you'll leave it overnight and come back the next day. The second piece of that is something I forgot earlier. You've got to get the mass of the filter paper before you do the experiment. So when you're cutting the filter paper for the funnel, you got to have the mass, because when we take the mass of this later, we need to subtract the mass of the filter paper so we can get the mass of the calcium carbonate that we produced.